about the adrenal glands. Adrenal glands, they are two in number and they are located at the top of each kidney in our body. And these adrenal glands, they are made up of two parts, that is the adrenal cortex, the outer part, the outer portion is known as adrenal cortex, whereas the inner portion is known as the adrenal medulla. Now this inner portion, that is the adrenal medulla, it secretes a hormone which is known as adrenaline. Adrenaline or epinephrine, or it is also known as emergency hormone, or it is also known as the stress hormone. Why it is known as, why these names have been given to this hormone? Because it produces a flight or fight response in our body in response to emergency situations. What are emergency situations? Like when a person is very angry, or he's very worried, or he feels very nervous, confused, he's in a condition of anxiety. At that time, the release of this hormone takes place and it helps a person to calm down during emergency situations. And what are the other effects produced by this hormone in our body? This hormone, it also stimulates the release of glucose from the liver, and so the blood sugar level, it increases, and then it increases the heartbeat, it raises the blood pressure, and when there is an increase of heartbeat or increase of blood pressure, then obviously the muscles, muscle cells, they receive more oxygen supply, and hence these they act immediately in response to these hormones. Then we talk about pancreas. Pancreas is a very important gland of our body, and it is both exocrine and endocrine gland. Why it is known as both exocrine as well as endocrine gland? It plays a dual function in our body. It is playing the role of an exocrine gland also as well as an endocrine gland also. Why? Because I told you exocrine glands are those which have ducts. So this pancreas, it is having a duct with the help of which it is secreting digestive enzymes into the small intestine. Since it secretes digestive enzymes, it is connected to the small intestine with the help of a small duct. So that is why it is known as an exocrine gland. Now why it is known as endocrine gland? Endocrine gland, it is known as because it has small clusters of hormone producing cells which are known as islets of Langerhans. And these clusters of hormone producing cells, they produce two types of hormones, that is insulin and glucagon. These are very important hormones in our body. And they both are antagonistic to each other. Antagonistic means they are opposite in function to each other. Now we'll talk about how they are opposite in function to each other. Like insulin is there. Insulin will stimulate the formation of glycogen from glucose. Glucose inside our body, it gets stored in the liver. So this hormone insulin, it stimulates the formation of glycogen from the glucose. And thus we can say that the it lowers the level of the blood sugar in our body. Whereas if we talk about this glucagon, then this glucagon, it stimulates the formation of glucose from the liver. And since it increases the blood sugar level, they both are opposite in function to each other. One is lowering the blood sugar level, insulin is lowering the blood sugar level, whereas this glucagon is raising the blood sugar level in our body. And what is known as diabetes mellitus? It is a very important question. Like we normally hear the patients, they say that I have diabetes and I have been told not to eat more of the sugary products. Diabetes mellitus is a condition in which the blood sugar level increases. Why the blood sugar level increases? Because the insulin hormone is produced in less amount. Pancreas does not work properly, and so there is less production of insulin. And so normally the doctors, they advise those diabetic patients who have more of the sugar level in their body, that is to take the insulin injection sometimes, because their body is not able to produce insulin. So insulin, it lowers the blood sugar level in our body. So next we talk about, there are different other endocrine glands. Like we have the pineal gland. The pineal gland is located within the brain, and The function of this gland is not fully known yet, but it plays an important part in the person's reproductive functioning, that is in the person's sexual development, that is when the reproductive organs, they are working properly, they are maturing properly or not. Then we have this parathyroid glands. Parathyroid glands, why they are known as parathyroid glands? Because they are situated in the thyroid gland. There are four small glands which are embedded in the thyroid gland. And their function is that they regulate the calcium and phosphorus level in our body. Then we have the thymus gland. Thymus gland is located behind the breastbone and it is present near the heart. And it releases a hormone, thymosin. And the function of this gland is that it produces antibodies. It boosts up a person's immune system. Antibodies, they are produced, they are proteinaceous molecules which are produced in our body in response to some foreign antigens. When some foreign particles or like the viruses or bacteria, they enter inside our body, then these antibodies or the proteinaceous molecules are produced in our body. And this is the work of these, we can say this thymus gland. It boosts up a person's immune system. So these were all the types of main types of endocrine glands. In a nutshell, I have told you about this chapter, endocrine system, about the various types of glands present in our body. Thank you.